I am Jos Westerbeke, and I work at the Erasmus University Rotterdam, the Netherlands, as a library IT specialist. And I'm pleased to tell you something about the FIM4L initiative, Federated Identity Management for Libraries. FIM4L is an activity initiated and headed by libraries. It involved people from around the world, librarians and related professionals in federated identity management. In October 2019, a LIBER working group has started for FIM4L. And FIM4L aims to develop a library policy for federated authentication that is broadly supported by and implemented by libraries and publishers. The authors firmly believe that it's important to protect the privacy of library users by keeping the handling of research library user information within the library administration. A library has many licenses to resources. To enter these, you have to authenticate. This is mostly done by IP authentication, but single sign-on or federated authentication is on the rise. Whenever a library has to configure single sign-on with a publisher, they have to be aware of the privacy of its patrons because of the possible exchange of personal information in the form of user attributes. The library has to protect its patrons. In order to make configuration and management of federated authentication easier for both libraries as well as publishers, FIM4L drafted a set of guidelines to control access to services based on licensed content. The document is almost published. We have talks with publishers and we work together with Seamless Access. And we just finished the final graphical version of our principles and recommendations, but the PDF is not published yet. But keep an eye on our website because it probably will be done this week. The document aims to function as a reference for libraries and publishers who want to set up a single sign-on connection, preserving the privacy. If we look into it, to the document, we see the principle 4. This is the core principle which describes the recommended configuration. There are two options. The library has to make a choice whether it will implement principle 4A or 4B. And if we look into that, we see what's called transitory access and personalized access. When a user logs into a website and is authenticated by its institutional single sign-on service, at least an identifier is released. This identifier could be a transient or a persistent identifier. The transient identifier means during accessing, the user is identified by a transient identifier, the name ID, containing a unique alphanumeric string for a certain service provider. If the user logs in again, a new transient identifier will be generated. A persistent identifier means like the transient one, but persisting by the service provider, the publisher, over multiple sessions. This ID can be traced back to a user by the library only. A personal profile on the website is possible by this configuration. One or the other ID are the only attributes the library needs to exchange with a publisher. Then the question comes, what can come along with this? For both configurations, the service provider can require extra non-identifiable information. Like you see here, the added person entitlement and the added person scoped affiliation. So that's FIM4L. If you have to set up a federated single sign-on with a publisher as a library, you can now use the document. Just go to FIM4L.org and you will find it there. But again, a new document, more the final document, more graphical, will be added, I think, this week.
Great, time's up, Jos, thank you.
Thank you. We have some questions for Jos on the chat window. The first question is, can you tell a bit about the other systems that also do the same kind of things? Like in Germany, you have the DFN AAI system. Is it the same technical structure, or does the FIM have different things that are different from what is used in other countries?
I'm sorry, but I don't get the abbreviation. But which system was speaking about?
Jakob is speaking about the DFN AAI, it's a German system.
Okay, I don't know, but what we do is we try to make some kind of policy to use. So it's not a technical configuration, but it's a guideline and a recommendation. What we think to be the best way to configure single sign-on, and we work together with Seamless Access. That's also if you look at the seamlessaccess.org website, you also find similar things like we do.
This is also part of the question that Herbert van de Sample has. So what is the connection with the Seamless Access? Okay. And is this a profile to implement Seamless Access technology?
Yeah, Seamless Access has indeed some technology to implement for the service providers, in our case the publishers. Seamless Access is more meant for the user experience, so you can easily log in. You can find a login button for institutional login, and then where are you from mechanism that works easy. So that's more the part what they are doing, more the part from the publisher, from the service providers, from the publishers, and we are more the part, or we aim to be the part from the libraries.
Yes, thank you. There's also a question from Till Kins. I think he is also mentioning there are related projects like the Swiss Switch AI and the EduGain in the United States.
Yes, we work together with EduGain and all other federations, the NRENs. They are very welcome to join us. I would recommend them if they like to join us, if they want to work with us, to go to the email, to subscribe yourself to our email list, as you see on the slide here.
Okay.